Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Two men are in hospital after being mauled in separate grizzly bear attacks, roughly 70 kilometers apart in southern Alberta's Rocky Mountains. At 12:47 p.m. Sunday, Kananaskis Emergency Services was notified of an attack on Storelk Mountain, south of Highwood Pass in Elbowsheet Wildland Provincial Park. A 38-year-old man was hiking alone when it's believed a female grizzly, who was with two cubs, defensively attacked, a spokesperson for Alberta Environment and Parks said. The man was airlifted from the backcountry to Foothills Hospital in Calgary. He'd received multiple serious puncture wounds and lacerations, and is in serious but stable condition. About 7 hours later, at 8 p.m., Blairmore RCMP received a call about a hunter who had been attacked by a bear. Two hunters were searching for grouse in an area about 10 kilometers west of Highway 40, near the Alberta-British Columbia boundary and south of Gould Dome Mountain, when they came across a grizzly sow and her cubs. The bear attacked one of the hunters, while the other shot the bear, scaring her off, officials said. The injured hunter is in hospital in stable condition, according to Alberta Fish and Wildlife. Fish and wildlife officers are searching for the bear, and the area of the attack is closed to the public. Fish and Wildlife said a map outlining the boundaries of the closed area will be provided as soon as it's available. Park staff are also looking for the bear involved in the earlier attack. A closure has been issued for Elbowsheet Wildland Provincial Park west of Highway 40 from the Peter Lougheed Provincial Park boundary south to an unnamed ridge south of Running Rain Lake off of Mount Oblum. A bear advisory is also in place for the Highwood area, which includes Ptarmigan Cirque, Pocatera Ridge, Lipset, Mist, and Pickle Jar Creek. The two maulings happen more than 70 kilometers apart. Experts say fatal bear attacks are rare. Bear activity is currently high, and encounters between bears and people may have unfortunate consequences for both the bears and people involved, an Environment and Parks spokesperson said. That's all for today, thanks for watching, see you soon with another video.